I'm Laura Paskus, and for this month's episode of Our Land, we visited the Carson National Forest to learn about a different type of forest management that's based on the acequia system. It's based on tradition and culture and meant to help the forest and the communities who live right next to it. A few years ago, J.R. Logan looked out across his backyard in San Cristobal in northern New Mexico. It was getting on toward fall when he and others who rely upon wood to heat their homes drive hours to other parts of the forest. Then they pay for U.S. Forest Service permits to collect wood.
It just made no sense to me, sitting in my valley, that I would have to go so far to get firewood when, looking literally out of my back door, there's a beautiful stand of ponderosas where the undergrowth has grown in thick and poses a huge risk to those trees and to my community and to the watershed. And I thought there just has to be a way where I can, you know, make it possible, where we can make it possible for me and my neighbors to be able to cut that wood, which is incredibly valuable to us as firewood and is in our own backyards, and at the same time, make our community and our watershed safer. We have
special protocols. Logan met with elders and leaders in his community.
Traditionally, we're a collectivist culture where the group is more important than the individual.
They got to talking about how to create a forest council and structure it as a community development project. They talked about acequias, land grants, and the long history of participatory democracy in northern New Mexico.
The governance, instead of creating a new system of governance, let's use the old ancient institutional forms of organization that we've had here for centuries, 300-400 years. And that is, the distribution of water has had a very appropriate and very successful governance system. The land grants also have had a long history of governance, very democratic, very participatory.
Parcientes, what it's called, parcientes, when it comes to a ditch. A parciente is a person that has a piece of land that needs irrigating. So they needed a mayordomo to oversee that.
They worked with the Carson National Forest, wrote a grant proposal, based bylaws on acequias and land grants, and they created the Cerro Negro Forest Council. Here, there are almost 300 acres of pinyon, juniper, and sage forest lands between the villages of San Cristobal and Valdez that need to be treated, thinned, so the forest is healthier, so it's closer to how it was before the U.S. government implemented fire suppression policies.
Our project in particular is designed to remove fuels that otherwise would really ramp up and supercharge fire behavior were we to see a fire occur in this area.
When the U.S. government stopped letting forests burn, they became overcrowded with smaller trees, all competing for water and sunlight and becoming additional fuel for wildfires, feeding them along with drought and rising temperatures to burn hotter and bigger than in the past.
This isn't a restoration project like you might see in ponderosa pine, where we're truly restoring an ecosystem to a place that it was millennia ago. Rather, this is restoration for the benefit of people, but also the benefit for the environment, in the sense that we're preventing what would otherwise be an uncharacteristic fire, especially as we see, you know, the climate getting warmer, hotter, and drier over the long run.
The Forest Service and the Council divided the forest here into 1-acre blocks and assigned them to leñeros, or woodcutters. Trees to remain are marked, and the others can be cut. A mayordomo oversees the work, and leñeros can use the wood at home or sell it, and the council pays them $300 an acre for their work. That's less than what the Forest Service pays contractors. And although the work can be slower, it's a model for other places too. Already, councils have popped up in southern Taos County.
My role in this is that I
I'm basically the leñero, the guy that cuts it and bucks it, takes it home, chops it up, and I use it for heating my home. It's my source of energy for heating back at the house. But yeah, I've been on this. I've already accomplished 3 1-acre blocks, and I'm currently working, just about finishing up my fourth. And I've got yet another one that I've been assigned that I've got to get started on and try to get that done before the end of the winter.
Having to drive 15 minutes as opposed to 2 hours to get a good load of the best wood that I can say there is to burn piñon, I mean, this is awesome. I'm really glad this opened up because I was getting kind of worried about finding places to go get wood there.
For Logan and leñeros like Cordova, their time in the forest isn't just about cutting wood. It's about connecting with the past and spending time with family.
Sometimes I just come out here and just sit around. I work really slow, and you know, I'm always looking for deer, of course. Now that it's so open after they've cleaned this up, I mean, you can really, you see more and of abundance of deer than what we used to in the past.
Historically, the relationship between the U.S. Forest Service and communities in northern New Mexico has been fraught, to say the least. The federal agency took over common lands when it was formed in the early 20th century, pushing people off their grazing lands and hunting grounds, requiring permits for wood cutting and pinyon gathering, closing access to the forests people had visited for generations. This council is a step toward healing, not just the land, but communities.
The whole north side. I think the situation right now is really nice in this respect that we're working with the Forest Service. Forest Service is cooperating with us. We're cooperating with them, and things are getting done. In some cases, not in all cases, is where a family comes out, you know. Mom and dad, and they bring 2 or 3 kids with them, and they're all helping. And then, of course, they take their little break for their little lunch or whatever, which is, you know, amazing. It's like nice.
Being a leñero is hard work, but there's an art to it too, and joy at being home in the forest.
Well, let's say this: this, in a sense, is a rancho, right? Rancho de leña de piñón. So why don't we say, allá en el rancho grande, allá donde vivía, había una rancherita que alegre me decía, there you go. From there on, it costs a dollar.
For Our Land and New Mexico in Focus, I'm Laura Paskus.